Hello my beautiful ladies, it's Greta here, Ladies Relationship Coach, and today my queens, I'm gonna share with you 5 ways on how to play hard to get. So let's just get on with it. Way number 1, let him chase you and text you always and forever first. Way number 2, cancel on a date or 2. Way number 3, hold on to have sex with him but sleep around with other guys. I mean, you want the relationship with this guy, so you have to hold on sex with this guy, but since you don't want anything serious with other guys, you can literally sleep around with them, right? Way number 4, flirt with others in front of his face a lot. Make sure that he can see all the attention that you're getting. And way number 5, be arrogant. So ladies, what will happen if you will actually follow these hard to get rules and stick with them? The only guy that will be after you if you will behave like this will be a guy who does not value nor respect himself, who does not love himself. You will behave like this, a guy who values himself, who respects himself, a high value man, will either just not put up with that and will just let you go, or he will mirror it and he will play it way harder than you do. And if a guy plays it way harder than you do, you're basically messing around with fire. You're playing with fire. And even if we look at the positive scenario, if you are behaving this way, and the guy, for some reason, is chasing you and pursuing you, as soon as you will stop playing hard to get, you will lose him ASAP. Why? Because he will be like, oh, actually, I really liked you when you were playing hard to get, but now you don't, you have changed, and I actually want this girl and not that one. So ladies, this is the reason why playing hard to get does not work. Now, let's look at all these 5 ways from the high value perspective, which actually does work and makes you look not like a game player, but a woman of high value. So the way number 1, where I said in hard to get, let him chase you and pursue you first, in a high value way, the way you do it naturally, so you are coming across as a high value woman, you go for your goals, dreams and ambitions, you put yourself first, you let a man pursue you, not because you're playing hard to get, but because by letting a man pursue you, you are actually fulfilling his need as a man. So intention behind it is totally different. You at the same time going for your goals, dreams and ambitions, loving yourself and putting yourself first, naturally you're not gonna be as quick to respond to his texts. You're not gonna look desperate because you're putting yourself first. When you're busy with your dreams, goals and ambitions, you're naturally not gonna be able to reply to his texts ASAP. And obviously, if you're free, it's okay to reply. If you're not free, if you're busy the whole day, well, it's good to reply it in your own time when you have that free moment and you actually want to take your time and enjoy replying to him. So the intention is totally different. It's not a game, it's a way of life. The second one where playing hard to get doesn't work, and as I'm saying, cancel on a date or 2 in the beginning. If you will cancel on a date or 2 in the beginning of dating, yes, some guys will pursue you more, but you're literally playing with fire because not every single guy will keep pursuing you when you're canceling. You might cancel on him once and he might continue to pursue him, but if you cancel on him twice, most likely he's gonna be done with you. Or worse, he will mirror that and then he'll start playing you at your own game. So ladies, the correct way, if a guy is arranging the date, if a guy has a plan for the date, if a guy is asking you out in advance, if he is the one pursuing you, he is already investing his time and energy into you. go on that date, enjoy that date, do not cancel on him. He's already doing literally all the work. He's already trying to impress you. Don't play with fire, girls. Enjoy the moment. Being high value is having the right balance. You don't want to be too bitchy, which is playing hard to get, and you don't want to be the one pursuing him and acting totally crazy, needy and desperate and like crawling on his neck. Being high value is having the right balance in life. The right balance in life is salty and sweet, all right? You need to have certainty and you need to have uncertainty. If you have too much uncertainty, it's not gonna work. If you have too much certainty, you're gonna get miserable, you're gonna get bored. It doesn't work. Has to be the right balance. The third tip of playing hard to get, oh my god, this one is cracking me up, but it does happen a lot. This is what girls are literally doing right now. They're sleeping around, they're having one night stands, but when they meet the guy that they like, oh, they withhold sex, oh, I like this guy, so I'm not gonna sleep with him ASAP. You know what, girls? If you are behaving like this, it's cool if you're getting away with it. But you can get caught. And actually, I'm gonna share a story with you. One of the girls that I'm coaching right now, she has a boyfriend with which one she hold on sex, right? When she went to the bar with her boyfriend, another guy came and he started pursuing her and she said she's not interested. When she went to the loo, he walked up to her boyfriend and he said to her boyfriend, oh, by the way, I had a one-night stand with your girlfriend. When the boyfriend confronted her about this guy, she lied to her boyfriend. She said, like, no, I never slept with him. But you don't want to put yourself in that situation, right? Be high value with every single guy, not just the guy that you like. Also, ladies, just take your time on having sex with the guy. You want a guy to like you for you. So if he's sticking around with you and he's taking you out and you guys are enjoying the moment for a while and you didn't even have sex, well, he might be a keeper. He might be into you. The fourth way, the way I described it in Hard to Get was flirt your ass off in front of his face, right? Ladies, if you will do that, you are playing with fire. Keeping your options open is wise, and I do recommend you doing that if you are dating the guy and you're not in a relationship, because he's obviously keeping his options open too. But there is no need to dangle these carrots in front of his face and make him jealous or provoke him like that. Yes, some guys will fight for you, some guys will mark their territory, but other guys, they will just be put off. So ladies, don't play with fire. Yes, keep your options open, but he doesn't need to know that you're keeping your options open. You're dating, you are available, you're single. Obviously, you're keeping your options open. If he wants you to be his girlfriend, he needs to ask you for it. That's it. Obviously, at the same time, do not lie to him. Don't say like, oh, I'm only dating you. No, but there is no need to make him jealous and show all these guys that are pursuing you. You know, keep it to yourself. When he's asking you, what are you doing, and you're actually on another date, just say, oh, I'm busy, and don't give him the details. You know, this is when his mind will start to wonder, oh, maybe she's keeping her options open, so I better get her before another guy does. You know, but don't do it like, oh, I'm out with the guy, I'm having such an amazing time, or flirting with other men in front of him. That's just not nice. That's ridiculous. The fifth one, playing hard to get, is being arrogant. Now, why being arrogant doesn't work? If you're playing hard to get and you're being arrogant and he likes that, well, guess what? You will have to be arrogant for the rest of your life, because when you will stop being arrogant, he will lose interest in you, because this is what he originally liked. All right? Anyway, there is a better way. I really don't recommend any girls to be arrogant. But if you're a challenge, if you're letting a guy pursue you, text you, arrange the dates and you are going on the dates with him. When you're going on the dates with him, have fun, enjoy the moment. But in the meantime, when you're not seeing him, don't be texting each other all the time. Stay a challenge. Let him miss you. Let him remember the fun dates that you guys are having together. Just don't be needy and crazy and pursuing in between the dates. Let him do this work, because actually he's a man and it's his job to pursue you. Let him do his work. So ladies, if you liked this video, please press like, subscribe to my YouTube channel. Let me know in the comments below, what do you think? Join my high value women group on Facebook, where we are all in the same boat, learning how to be women of high value and bring out the best in our men. Follow me on my Instagram. My Instagram is called ladiesrelationshipcoach.com. And if you would like me to hold your hand and help you to bring out the best in your guy, you can always book me through my website, which is called ladiesrelationshipcoach.com. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Have a beautiful day, and kisses from London. Mwah.